So even before Prime Minister Yin Lak visit Cambodia tomorrow, that is Thursday, Kun Wirat Somkhamkit and Kun Ratri, who have been jailed, I think, for at least 6 months or so, have been released, which was quite surprising because originally the indication from Phnom Penh was that when Kun Thaksin arrives there, then Hun Sen will show his friendliness to Kun Thaksin and the new government of Thailand by releasing the couple. But it happens much sooner than we expected.
It's all but confirmed today that the two activists will be released, and possibly Kun Ying Lak will return to Thailand tomorrow with the two activists. That's the best case scenario, but absolutely the two will be released any time soon now.
So what does that mean politically to the government and to the Yellow Shirt Movement?
Right, and a lot of questions are being asked about the Yellow Shirt Movement at the moment, whether the PAD now has owed some debt of gratitude to this Ying Lak government and probably Kun Thaksin Shinawat as well. So what will happen in the future if there's a Ying Lak government is introducing some amnesty program for Kun Thaksin, and what will the Yellow Shirt do at that time? And also the questions will be asked about the resolve of the PAD when it comes to the Prawihan issue.
Yeah, because the PAD has yet to come up with an official statement on this.
No, but we have heard some interesting quotes from certain PAD members. Kun Suliyasai, who we consider a moderate PAD leader, he said that we thank the Ying Lak government for giving importance to life and liberty of Thai people languishing overseas. And a little bit of hardcore member of the PAD, Kun Chai Wat Sinsu Wong. And he said the release of Kun Wira and Kun Latri is a slap in the face of the opposite government.
So it depends on, you know, where you are looking from. If you are sort of moderate Yellow Shirt, you would think that at least you have to make a polite statement thanking the government.
Yes.
But at the same time, I think officially the PAD, you know, under Son Thit Lim Thong Kun and Jam Long, we have to make a statement as well.
Yes, and everyone will be very interested in, we'll be looking forward to hearing from Kun Jam Long and Kun Son Thit very much.
Well, well, that could be considered part of the reconciliation process in the country.
Yes, it's quite an irony because Red Shirt, the pro-Red Shirt government has succeeded in securing the release of the Yellow Shirt activists. So this is very interesting.
But then some critics will say this is a political game, you know, because Hun Sen used to say, when Apisit was prime minister here, that no, no way, they will have to serve at least two-thirds of the term.
Yes, so the rule, he cannot bend the rule to help the Thai activists. Yes. But now, obviously, the rule has been bent, obviously, by the Hun Sen government.
So it could be seen as a, you know, political game to for Hun Sen to play with one government in Thailand and with the other. So in a way, that is... you can call it a hostage game as well, if you know, you want to be crude about it. But then you're all happy that Kun Wira and Kun Ratri are free because their detention was controversial in the first place.
Yes.
Because there was argument that they did not do anything seriously wrong. They were just inspecting the border.
There were even questions about whether they were arrested on the controversial overlapping area, or they did cross into the Cambodian side of the border.
But you know, everything is well that ends well. But then we will see what happens when Kun Ying Lak visits Cambodia tomorrow, and the day after, it will be Kun Thaksin's turn. And I hear that the court has given permission for the some of the Red Shirt leaders
to visit Cambodia.
To visit Cambodia to arrange for a football match.
Another big development in Thailand today is the court permission. Because you know, the reason for the red shirt leaders to visit Cambodia is not a life and death matter. It's yeah. about going to Cambodia to
play football,
play football to some cordial visit yeah. In the country. So, and these people who were given permission to go there, they are facing serious yes. charges in Thailand. So, the court decision today has a lot of significance, political significance.
Yeah, you know, the sort of reconciliation signals are being sent all around, and I hope that it would lead to better atmosphere politically in the country.